wanted to ask you, what is your message? Why is are you sitting on the hunger strike? Yeah.
The thing is that now the Tibet is becoming very critical. Because of the Chinese occupation of Tibet in 1959, now it's Tibetan people inside Tibet. Now it's turning, 51 sub-immolators inside Tibet. So at this situation, we, the Tibetan people in exile, cannot, remain like silent. We are the voice of the voiceless Tibetan inside Tibet. So on behalf of these people, we want to, United Nations, European Union, and other international bodies to intervene in the Tibetan issue. We are requesting to the United Nations and European Union and other international bodies. We want to thank them for accepting the, at the demand of the two-state hunger strike that has been organized by TYC before. And to follow up that, they have accepted the demand. Now we are requesting the international bodies to implement the acceptance that they have made regarding the TYC hunger strike. So we are requesting the United Nations and other international bodies to send a fact-finding delegation inside Tibet so that they can find out the real situation inside Tibet, so that they can access the ground realities inside Tibet. And we are also, nowadays China is, arresting so many Tibetans, giving the sentence from different years, in different terms. So in that context, we are, urging the Chinese government not to, arrest the Tibetan, innocent Tibetan people. And also, China has said that, the self-immolators are just, useless people, and so many baseless allegations has been made. And we are demanding China to stop such kind of allegations. Tibetan Youth Congress recognized the self-immolation is the highest non-violent action of the Tibetan struggles. And also I want to, request not only to the international community, but also people around the globe to support the cause of Tibet. That Tibet, we are talking about the world peace, but Tibet today becomes very much critical, and Tibet becomes battleground of the Chinese people. Chinese are killing so many Tibetans inside Tibet. So that in that way, I'm requesting, I on behalf of Three Hunger Strikes, requesting to the international community as some people around the globe to support the cause of Tibet.
How and what kind of a rights violation exists in Tibet, inside Tibet? What are the information that you are getting there?
There are no human rights because of the can understand probably because of the self-immolation that has been made by Tibetan people. This self-immolation is not something that you can easily done. It is sacrificing life, their own life, because of the duty to the frustration of Chinese occupation of Tibet. The self-immolator has demanded that return of Dalai Lama to Tibet and also freedom in Tibet, which you can clearly understand the situation inside Tibet. China, each and every day, Tibetan people inside Tibet has, unable to sleep properly. They are not, properly able to eat their own food. In such kind of situation, they are under such critical situation. This kind of situation is happening with the Tibetan people. As I said, with the Tibetan people in exile, cannot sit alone like this. We should do something for the Tibetan people to save the Tibetan people inside Tibet. To regain the independence of Tibet is the most important thing for the Tibetan people. If Tibet got its independence, then there will be no such kind of actions. Because of Chinese occupation of Tibet, now today Tibetan people are facing the brutalities of China, repressions, oppression, everything is happening inside Tibet.
What were the promises made by Ban Ki-moon at New York?
In the last, we laid down four demands that time to send the fact-finding delegations to, pressure the Chinese government to stop martial law inside Tibet, to release the political prisoners, including Gendun Chögyal, the highest tribunal. So all the demand that during that time in New York hunger strike, the Secretary General and his delegate, his representative visited the hunger strikes, and hand out the letter and also said that they are going to accept the demands of the hunger strikers. So they have accepted all the demands of the TYC hunger strikers. Now we are, you know, appealing to the international communities and international bodies, including the United Nations, to implement the demands that they have accepted. So that's why we are here in this hunger strike to follow up the previous two demands that we have laid down in the front of European Union and, you know, United Nations. They already accepted. Now we want to implement the demand they have, you know, accepted.
What kind of interference they make in the religious affairs in Tibet?
So in Tibet, you know, you must be knowing that even the people are not allowed to keep the portrait of Dalai Lama. You know, for Tibetan people, Dalai Lama is everything, you know. It's much more important than one's own life. In such condition, you know, they are not allowed to keep the portrait of Dalai Lama. You are not allowed to, you know, worship the Dalai Lama. This is just one, you know, kind of. Even in the monasteries, there are too many restrictions, you know. Everywhere, monastery means it is a place where everybody can worship or pray or do some kind of religion rituals. But nowadays, monastery has become a like military, you know, base. All the entire premises of the, you know, monastery has been, you know, Chinese militaries. In such kind of, you know, situation, one has to, you know, like I said, we the Tibetan people in exile, we cannot sit alone like this. So in that way, we trying to be a representative, you know, voice of the voiceless Tibetan inside Tibet.
And what do you expect from the government of India in this regard?
I feel that, you know, government of India should be bold regarding their own foreign policies, especially dealing with China, you know. Government of India should know, you know, if Tibet got independence, there's much advantage for the government of India. If you look at the security, you know, from Ladakh to Arunachal Pradesh, more than 2,500 kilometers. Before 1959, there were, you can hardly find 12 policemen in the, you know, border between Tibet and, you know, India. Now, since Chinese occupation of Tibet, the border between, you know, in China and, you know, now its border becomes like China and India. In that way, India is spending crores of money in a day, especially in those regions. So I requesting, you know, to the government of India to be, you know, little bit bolder, you know, in their foreign policies. I also want to request the government of India to accept the independence of Tibet, because India knows very much about the independence of Tibet. So I'm appealing to the government of India to stand up for the independence of Tibet. I should say that Tibet independence is the security for India. That way I want to appeal to the, not only to the people of government of India, but also to the people of India to stand up for the independence of Tibet, to support the independence of Tibet, so that it can benefit millions of poor Indians, which located in different regions in India. The money that the Indian government today is spending at the border region can be used at the development of the other region of India. If once Tibet got independent, there will be no such kind of problem that will be exist. So that way I'm, you know, requesting to the government of India, because for the benefit of India, India should stand up and India should declare the independence of Tibet, and India should, you know, support the independence of Tibet.
It's just about 6 day trip. Today is your 6th day.
Sorry?
Of the hunger strike.
Today is the day 6.
Yes. So, have you got any feelers, anyone who has visited you and expressed something?
Some visitors came. There are so many, you know, Indian supporters who also showed their solidarities in the past few days. And we are very much thankful to them. And I was also expecting that they are in the coming days, more Indian will come up, you know, because as I said, you know, India, Tibet independence is the security of India.
And how long are you going to be here?
Until our demands are fulfilled, you know, we are going to sit for it. We don't bother about our own life, you know, because the Tibetan people inside Tibet are, you know, sacrificing their important life. So we, the Tibetan people in exile, should do something. We are in a country where it's a democratic, where there's a freedom and everything. In such country, you know, we cannot remain like silent. So in that way, you know, even if it costs our life, we don't mind. because it will be our fortune to, give our life for the country, for the course of Tibet.